All right, we're back with the amazing Gloria Estefan. Yay!
Hey,
I'm here.
Gloria, I know you've been working on new music, and I hear you've got an announcement to make for everybody.
I do. I've actually been working on this album for such a long time. You know, when I lost my mom almost 3 years ago, I was intending to get into the studio to record it, my part of it, and I couldn't sing. So I, you know, postponed it. We recorded it. We've been waiting for the right moment. And I really think it's not a better moment right now than when the world needs some, you know, music, some fun music to, you know, kind of get them out of this, the doldrums of being locked away. So I've loved Brazilian music since I joined the band. I made them learn all these songs, Corcovado, Desafinado, Girl from Ipanema, when I joined. We did a whole album called Rio back in the day, one of our early albums. And now I'm revisiting the music of Brazil. We've reimagined 11 of our big hits, As If I Was Born in Brazil. We shot a documentary down there that goes into the roots of how samba was born, because samba is actually a very political movement in Brazil. And with four new songs, and it is going to finally come out on August 13th, which the 13 is our family lucky number.
Yeah, I
think Brazil. So. Yes, Brazil 305.
Yes,
our area code here. It's like Miami to Brazil. It's a love letter to that music, which any musician, I'm sure Marie, you know how wonderful Brazilian music is.
The best.
And I re-sang everything. We redid versions. I wrote new lyrics. I did all kinds of things, and I'm very thrilled that this is going to come out. We'll probably have a single, a dance single for the summer, so we can get out there and in the clubs and you know, enjoy some dance music again. But I'm thrilled that it's finally going to be out. I'm sure my fans are going to love that, because they've been going, when is it coming out? When is it coming out? August 13th.
Yeah. Fantastic. And Gloria, in a few minutes, you will be performing your song Reach, which we all remember as one of the anthems of the 1996 Olympics. So why did you choose this song? And is there anyone you'd like to dedicate it to?
Well, this song, when they asked me to do the Olympics, I freaked out because it's an anthem, you know, it's a daunting task. But then I realized that if I thought about what it took for me to get out of bed each day and get out there after my accident and reach those goals that I talked to you about, I wanted to write a song that you could just play, anybody could play on their guitar, that would empower them to always reach for the next level, for the next best thing, for the next moment. So I'd really like to dedicate it to all those first responders out there, all the our medical people, our paramedics, the people that are serving us in grocery stores and delivering our food to us, that are really taking a chance and putting their health on the line by serving humanity. And that song is supposed to be, you know, striving for that moment when everything is great and what it takes to get there. And yeah, I'd like to dedicate that to them.
It's one of your most powerful songs. I love it. It's one of my favorites. So now you've joined forces with Jada Pinkett Smith, right? For an upcoming book series, the Red Table Talk, right?
Yes.
And the Estefans, which is your daughter and your niece, they're going to be your co-hosts, right?
Yes.
So are you worried about what they might say about you?
You're worried? No. Ready for it? Totally. Because they're gonna make it tough. We're gonna make it tough on each other. We just love to razz each other, but we really are a very tight-knit group. We love each other. Lily, my niece, actually lived with us when they came from Cuba for a long time. Even though I'm only 8 years older than her, I've kind of been her mom, because she lost her mom in Cuba when she was very young. And my daughter's already doing it. We went over to the Pinkett Smith's home, which is, oh my God, spectacular, and where they shoot Red Table Talk. And they asked, you know, they were filming some social media stuff, and they say to each of us, okay, think of one word that represents the other person. And when, you know, I said all these beautiful things about my daughter and Lily, and when they go to my daughter, her first word was fossil. I go, okay, thanks. I'm changing my word for you. It starts with a B and it rhymes with hitch.
Now, quickly, I want to ask you, because besides music, you and your husband run several hotels and restaurants, and they've been hit and affected, obviously, by the coronavirus. But you guys have found a way to keep your employees going right now. Can you tell us about that, please?
Yes, of course. Well, any musician, as you well know, unless you're out there touring, making music and making money off of music has totally changed. I mean, the business of music is in a different place. So Emilio and I, years ago, we decided to diversify into restaurants, which I love because it was my grandma's dream to have one. And I grew up in the kitchen with her. So we thought music, food go together great. So we have several restaurants and two hotels. And yes, everything is shut down. We were, especially on the beach, we were the first ones shut down. So we teamed up with CVS Navarro, which were wonderful, and we're looking for employees. They needed more people to help the demand. And since we have all our employees are vetted and have great background checks and we have great relationship, they took on our employees that serve on, you know, in the restaurants and the hospitality. And we are so thankful, you know, to keep them working. Of course, the ones that want to, we didn't, you know, force them to do it, but the ones that are willing. And yeah, we're trying everything we do to hang on to every employee to try to get through this moment, because it is a tough time for all the business owners out there. But we just got to try to hang on and try to make it through this crisis, and things will pop back. I know. I think it'll take a while, because I think if people's mentality to try to just jump into crowds is not going to be there. But, you know, we'll just get through it. We got to move forward. That's all we can do, you know, help each other get through this.
That's right. We can do that. And you're going to help all of us when we come right back, because Gloria is going to perform her inspiring Grammy-nominated song, Reach, for all of us. Don't go away.